During a briefing this week in Geneva, Monsignor Robert Vitillo reported about the status of the Ebola crisis, especially in Liberia, and the Catholic Church's response through their charity organizations.
Catholic Relief Services, which is a member organization of Caritas Internationalis from the United States, has dedicated itself more to helping the Catholic Church structures in those countries keep the other health services open. And so it's just made a major commitment in Liberia, for instance, to buy the supply of medicines for the Catholic health clinics for the whole year, and also to provide the PPE, personal protective equipment for those health clinics. The Catholic Church is very involved in the three most heavily affected countries, Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea. Much of the work has been to educate people about the facts around Ebola, because there's so much fear and panic and misinformation that goes out among the people. So the church is a credible witness. It's a place where people come for good information, and we're able to do this through the churches, through the masses, but also then the Caritas organizations and other Catholic organizations in these countries are reaching out to train people at village level, to train the priests and the religious and the lay catechists to be able to get the information out. Basic information like how do you prevent the spread of Ebola through simple means, simply by hand washing and other means like that, by keeping a distance from people, by not touching people who already are showing the symptoms of Ebola, and especially by avoiding contact, direct physical contact with the bodies of people who have died of Ebola. So we're doing that in the parishes and in the local communities. We're also getting involved in responding with food aid, because many of the people who have ill members in their family are not longer able to keep up their farming and their agriculture. Also, for those families who are suspected of being infected, they have to stay isolated for 21 days. And so the parishes are bringing food to those families since they cannot leave their homes. And then finally, we have the formal healthcare sector that the Catholic Church operates in many countries, especially in developing countries. For example, in Liberia, 14 of the 16 Catholic health clinics remain open, while many of the governmental health clinics and other private facilities are closed. And so it's continuing its care for the sick beyond Ebola to make sure that we can take care of those who have other illnesses or who are victims of automobile crashes and things like that. And now we're working very, very hard to get reopened the Catholic hospital in Monrovia, which was closed after it lost 9 of its staff members to Ebola. But now we're working on making sure that we have careful prevention methods and facilities before people get into the hospital, and we want to reopen that facility as soon as possible.
This Ebola situation affects all sectors of society. The Catholic Church has been very instrumental in terms of providing supports, psychosocial support, to different populations in different areas. And now these people need this support more than ever before. There are a lot of orphan children too that require care. There's a need to provide humanitarian assistance to people affected by the Ebola crisis. And I think in all these areas, we have seen the Catholic Church, Caritas, do a great job both in times of peace and during the war too. So we see them as doing this right now because we need this support. We also need in education support, which is something else that the Catholic Church has done very well. Because one thing that has happened during this crisis is that schools are closed. And there are all sorts of makeshift classes. There are classes by radio, etc. But this would also help children to overcome the trauma too, because children who have lost their parents and they still cannot go to school and they do not have any care. So there's a lot of work there that can be done within the communities by Caritas to help us in handling this emergency.
The Ebola briefing concluded with a prayer for the victims and health workers and to find a cure.
Let the words of your Son, Jesus Christ, in the Our Father, be our prayer as we entrust ourselves and those affected by Ebola to your infinite and inscrutable power and love. Amen.